Hi, I'm Christian. Hello and welcome to the sixth episode of ctrlX developer. Most of you know already during the show we present to you the features and possibilities what ctrlX automation can offer to you. For those of you who don't know it yet and who want to learn a little bit more about ctrlX core, the data layer, the SDK or the device portal, you will find the corresponding links to the previous sessions in the description below, or you can follow us on our YouTube channel. We've shown you now a lot of things what you can do with ctrlX automation, but today we will see how you or we or our partners can add more and more features and solutions to the platform. And for that, I have our super nerd Johannes again with me. So hello and welcome, Johannes.
Hi everybody, it's good to be here again.
So today you will explain to us how any programmer or any company can create an app for our ctrlX automation platform. And later on we have a special guest with us who can show us the whole thing with a real life example.
Yes, that's the plan for today. As some of you might already know, I'm one of the software developers for ctrlX automation. And today I want to show you something about the ctrlX world, the ecosystem of our platform.
Then let's get started. We're all curious.
Good. With ctrlX automation, we have many advantages in terms of software. Our platform is open and app-based. And with a software development kit, which I presented to you already in episode 5, you have numerous possibilities to complement ctrlX automation with various apps and functions. And since the innovation doesn't stop with us, we launched in September the ctrlX world with more than 15 partners already.
In the previous episodes, we learned already that there are numerous apps already available, like the ctrlX Motion app, the PLC app. But what you say is that any programmer can create an app for the ctrlX automation platform. Is that correct?
That's completely correct. Companies have the opportunity to put already existing apps in our ctrlX app store or program it by themselves and upload it after that.
Okay, so in other words, third-party apps officially supported by Bosch Rexroth.
Exactly. This gives these companies the opportunity to offer software solutions for their products, for example. And this expands the functional scope of their hardware.
Okay, and on the other hand, all the users of ctrlX automation, they can get these apps via our App Store, download them, install them, and add new features, functionalities, solutions without programming themselves.
I see you got it.
Don't get smarter than me. Okay, how does it work with the partner apps? How do the partner apps get on our ctrlX automation platform?
Of course, we support our partners in the creation of their own app. On the one hand with our SDK and on the other hand via the community or in person, so they can connect their products to our platform quickly and realize every idea to make ctrlX automation even better.
Cool. Can you tell us which partners are already on board?
At the moment, we have partners from very different areas. For example, suppliers who are building an app to make their mechatronic systems even more intelligent, like Wittenstein or Schunk. Or companies who say, with the ctrlX data layer, they have all the data correctly classified in a central place, and then they can build an AI app more easily.
Okay. Normally, it's a big problem to have easy access to sorted data. But thanks to our ctrlX data layer, the data on the ctrlX core is semantically pre-sorted, right?
Right. And then there's the topic of cloud connection and visualization. The company Mirasoft, for example, built an app via our SDK, which sends the data from the control directly to their cloud portal. And with this, they're able to monitor a water work, for example, via a simple user interface.
On top of that, of course, there's also a lot of factory IT software that controls the production.
Exactly, in a classic way. We cooperate with the company Forcam. There will be a connector app which sends the data from the ctrlX core directly to the MES system, a system for production planning in real time.
Wow, that sounds like an enormous amount of programming work.
That's my keyword. Because the great thing is, thanks to our open architecture, partners rarely develop their solution for ctrlX automation from scratch, but bring already existing software code to our system. So, for example, the solution is already there, and with our SDK, they bring it into the ctrlX world.
So, once you have programmed something, you can easily repack it, and you're immediately on the automation platform with your own idea.
This is exactly the benefit. This can be done with little effort if you program your app in a common programming language like Python and C++. We have partners who are trying this out and they make good experience with it. Now they can use what they have developed over the past years. The gearbox company Wittenstein, for example, created their own app within a few days.
But you could also start from scratch.
Of course, anything is possible. Maybe you have already existing code which you need for a connection or a new idea and can use them further. But even from scratch, we are happy to help.
So how do you become a partner? Could I, as a small startup company, become a partner?
Of course, there are already areas of interest, machine learning, for example. But in the end, companies with good ideas or good apps, which bring great value for our common customer or the ctrlX world, whether for mechatronic solutions or as an own app, are welcome.
Good to know. But how do those partner apps get to the customers? Is there a defined process?
Definitely. So as already mentioned, we offer the partner apps through our ctrlX App Store, which can be accessed directly from the ctrlX core or from the internet.
So as we all know it from our smartphone.
Exactly. That's the same logic as for smartphones. Before the app ends up in the store, it goes through a signing process. And before the app is made available to customers, it goes through a review process by us and receives a signature.
100% safe and secure.
That's right. It can be also installed directly on the control, which only allows signed apps. And the Snap container format provides security. And all the partners naturally use all the security aspects automatically.
I see. You don't have to worry about security at all. You simply start to program within our security architecture, which we provide. How did you come up with the idea of partner apps? Or when was it clear that ctrlX automation needs an official app store?
Due to our open system, we have completely new possibilities as far as software is concerned. And one of the possibility is to bring innovative companies on board, not only with their components, but also with their products like apps.
So this is a direct result of our app-based design of ctrlX automation.
That's right. The customers are now able to expand the system with software that does not come from Bosch Rexroth. That was one of the goals of our open system. And it was only logical to provide partners with an environment that is secure and convenient so they can pass these possibilities on to customers.
So our customers don't have to wait for us to provide a solution for their specific functionalities. They could either start programming by themselves or use the software of one of our partners.
Yes, that's right.
Now we've heard the theory, but some of you may miss the practical part like in the previous sessions. For this, we have another guest with us. We invited Thomas Hepp, one of the founders of Mirasoft, and he will show us one of the first highlight applications today. So welcome, Thomas, and we're really happy to have you here.
Christian, thanks for inviting me. It's a real pleasure for me.
Please introduce yourself and tell us what you're doing at Mirasoft.
Like you said, I'm one of the founders of Mirasoft, but I'm also the developer who developed the app which connects the ctrlX to the cloud system AnyViz.
Can you please explain a little bit more in detail what kind of services and features Mirasoft offers?
Mm-hmm. With our AnyViz cloud, we enable customers to remotely monitor, operate, and analyze their machines. You can create dashboards and reports with just a few clicks. And the data analysis functions helps to make processes transparent and to increase efficiency. So I have always an overview of all your industrial assets. And if something unexpected happens, you have the ability to react.
And this all happens in the cloud?
Yes, but to achieve this, we need the data from the shop floor. In case of ctrlX, this is very convenient because all the data are already collaborated in the ctrlX data layer. And this is where our AnyViz Cloud Adapter app comes into play. It collects the data from the data layer and transmits it encrypted to the cloud.
Okay. How did you first get in touch with ctrlX automation?
Basically, we have been in contact with Bosch Rexroth since our company was founded. We support the Rexroth PLCs from the very beginning. And since we are only 8 kilometers away from here, we are always up to date with new products and new developments. And as we first heard about the ctrlX, it was clear for us that we want to be part of it from the beginning. So we started the development very fast.
So please tell us, how fast did you develop your app and did the SDK make it easier for you?
it all happened very fast. The technical basis of ctrlX and its SDK is exactly what we were looking for. We feel very comfortable with Ubuntu Core and C++, so it was very easy for us to develop the app. After about 1 week, we had a stable snap.
And what do you like about ctrlX automation?
Two things. First, that ctrlX is open and extensible. The time of closed systems is really over, so we were very happy about the concept of ctrlX. The second thing is that customers need a solution that is easy to use. Our customers want to get started immediately without hours of training, and this is exactly what ctrlX enables.
So let's try this out. So I log into the ctrlX core. And for today, I prepared a little PLC application. As you see, I learned a little bit about programming PLC. So here's my PLC application, and this PLC application moves to virtual access. And now I want to push this data into the cloud. And to push this data in the cloud, I don't want to program an app by myself. So I take a look in our ctrlX automation community in the app zone. And there I found the Mirasoft AnyViz cloud adapter. And now I download it and install it on the ctrlX core. So I prepared the download already, and I go to the packet manager and switch the ctrlX core to the service mode to install the app. So now I'll go to the local storage and install the AnyViz cloud adapter. Now it is installed, and I bring the device back to operational. And after I installed the app successfully, it's better to hand over to Thomas. He can explain his app best.
Thank you, Johannes. Basically, you have done the main work. Now only a few clicks are left to finish the onboarding process. We have already registered in the AnyViz cloud, so we have an empty project here with the number 1419. And if we open the UI of the AnyViz cloud adapter, we have to enter with project number. And we have to enter an onboarding password. This password is required to ensure that the cloud adapter connects to the correct project and vice versa. If we now click on submit, a new cloud adapter appears in the AnyViz cloud. The orange bar indicates that the onboarding process is not yet finished. So we click on settings, and here we can give them a name, and we have to confirm the onboarding password. If we now click on OK, the onboarding process is finished.
That's it? What happens here in the background?
Yes, the ctrlX core is now permanently connected to the cloud, and the ctrlX data layer has already been transferred and is now available in the cloud.
And data gets already exchanged?
Not yet. Only the data which is actually needed in the project is transmitted. So we can start creating a small dashboard. Thanks to Johannes, we have some data from Access and can now use this data to create some dashboard. So let's search about the Access. Here we have Access 1 and see the values actual and can drag and drop, for example, the position. The first time we use a data point, we have to enter some details, but we can do it later also. Access 1, position, and then we click on OK. And first of all, we can display the access position as simple text. We can do this also for access 2, state values actual position, we can drag and drop here and name it access2pos and display it also here in text form. And now let's add some bar display also here for access1. Here we have to enter the minimum and the maximum. Let's duplicate it here for access2. And let's display the access positions perhaps in a chart. Let's add the access position 2. adduce the series type as spline. And at least we can add some metrics, perhaps the CPU utilization. Matrix system, CPU utilization. And now we have another chart. And in less than 1 minute, we have a small dashboard.
Wow, I just watched how you created such a cloud-based dashboard in basically no time.
Not only visualizations, the data can also be recorded for later analyses in AnyViz. Or additionally, you can use condition monitoring. If an alert occurs, you will receive a push notification or a voice call from the portal.
Thank you so much, Thomas. We're really excited about your new app.
Yes, it's really impressive. And of course, we are still looking for cool applications, exciting business models to keep expanding our platform so that our customers and partners are always two steps ahead. So if you have a good idea, get in touch with us and together we bring your app into the ctrlX world.
What a perfect conclusion, Johannes. Thank you for giving us this introduction and all this information on this topic. And of course, thank you for Thomas for being here and giving us this exciting insight. Good. In the next episode, on November 26, we will deal with a much-asked aspect of security. We will show you what makes our system not only very open, but also extremely secure. So just click on the subscribe button to make sure you won't miss the next episode. Until then, catch you on the next one to be two steps ahead. We'll be right back.